Hello, ladies and gentlemen, my name is Mengs! And are you guys ready for a vacation to the Western Isles? Man, I'd love to vacation in the Western Isles. Just imagine sitting on that beach, enjoying like a nice Pepsi Max while looking at the sunset, and then being kidnapped and forced to work as a slave in the mines. Man, I can't think of a better vacation. Listen to this track, though. I love this track. One of my favorite Fire Emblem tracks of all time. Anyway, after driving Narshan away from Ostia, Roy and company brace themselves for further attacks from Bern. However, Bern's belligerent movements towards Lycia come to an abrupt halt, as if to mock Roy in his caution. Bern also maintains a neutral position of an offer of a treaty from Etruria. Bern's sudden silence and lack of activity can only be described as eerie. With Hector gone, Farah is now the greatest power in Lycia. Elliewood summons the Council of Marquesses to Farah to discuss future actions. It is decided that Elliewood is to lead the Council of the Lycian League. A new Lycian army is also to be established. This new army's purpose is not to take the offensive against Bern, but rather to take a defensive stance for Lycia. Owing to his victory against Bern in Ostia, Roy is chosen the leader of this new army. Gradually, the attitude and morale in Lycia begins to improve. People once again conduct business without fear, and they embrace a new optimism. At this time, Etruria calls for Lycia's assistance. The kingdom needs help with restoring law to the Western Isles. Many outlaws make their bases there, and anarchy is said to rule. Many in Lycia are eager to send their troops to the Isles to deal with bandits, but having received Etruria's aid in Ostia, they have no choice but to oblige. Thus, Roy and the Lycian army pass through Etruria toward the Isles. The Western Isles are the numerous islands of the western coast of Alibe. Presently, they are colonies of Etruria. The Western Isles are rich in resources, so mining is a major industry there. However, these resources are also worth a fortune. Inevitably, varied bands of rogues travel there hoping to loot the mines. As such, the people of the Western Isles live in constant fear of bandit attacks. Roy is sent to vanquish these bandits. Or is he? Let's find out. Yay, you know what we get to see? Oh, wow. Looks like we have more line of sight than we otherwise have. Pretty sure you're not able to see the middle island without a torch normally. Yeah, ladies and gentlemen. Oh boy, okay, so here comes the big thing that I've decided to do. So a lot of people want me to show off both routes. If you don't know, there's a route split. You visit this village, you get Echidna. You visit this village, you get Bartra. What I'm actually going to do is I'm going to visit both of them. I'm going to hold it off until the very end of the map. I'm going to make a save, and then I'm going to do one route and then another. I think I'm going to do Echidna's route first and then Bartra's route. And I'm going to inevitably end up with Bartra as the playable character that I end up carrying with me, because I want to see both the maps. I love the Echidna map, but I do want to try out Bartra in this hack, and I want to see all the how all the units are. So that's going to be interesting, I think. So this is chapter 8. This is where you get Fear and Shin. They show up here. I'm very excited to see what they've done with Fear. I imagine they've just buffed her basis, but it's still going to be cool to see. Love the new pirate animations. That's really cool. For this map, I like to use Shana to like drop off some units on the top island. I might also drop someone off here, but I need to get rid of these archers first. And with their 3-range bows, that probably means I can just position Volt here. Speaking of Volts, apparently I lost out on a personal bow for him. That's really sad. I read in the comments that if he speaks to Lalina in Chapter 8, he gets a personal bow. That's very sad. I wish I had gotten that, but yeah, now we'll never know. I guess you guys are just gonna have to tell me how amazing it is in the comment section below. But yes, I'm gonna bring these guys right here. Bringing Sue, of course. We need her to recruit Shin, and we need Noah to recruit Fear. So, without further ado, ladies and gentlemen, let us go! And yes, we are using Fear. I've already decided we're using Fear, because she's amazing. Chapter 9, The Misty Islands Old, to caverns deep and dungeons old. Boss, the Lycians are here.
You sure?
Oh yeah, we just saw them dock on that little island in the east.
Good, they're probably floundering around in this thick fog. Sneak up from where they can't see and finish them.
Sure thing, boss.
Roy, I'm sorry I couldn't stop this.
Isn't it your isn't your responsibility, General. I thought he said, isn't it your responsibility? Like, oh, being all sassy, like, it isn't your responsibility, General Cecilia. Don't concern yourself. Even in Etruria, people dislike how the High Chancellor treats the Lycian as pawns.
High Chancellor? I thought the King made a decision to send us here.
Actually, he didn't. High Chancellor Rhodes works closely with Lord Arcardo, the noble who heads the mining operations here in the Western Isles. They made the decision without consulting the King.
They have that power? How?
Did you hear of the tragedy that occurred with Darth?
Sorry.
I couldn't help myself. did you hear the tragedy that occurred in Etruria last year? Of course. Prince Murden, next in line to the king, abruptly passed away last year. Yes, that's it. I never had the honor to make his acquaintance. I understand that he was a very bright individual. Yes, were the prince alive, Etruria would surely not be in this sad shape. King Mordred was overcome with sorrow when his son departed. The shock was so great that he has yet to recover. Of late, it seems he's always detached from reality. He pays no mind to anything happening around him or in the kingdom. Rorts is exploiting the king's condition for his own benefit. Now he's essentially in charge of the going-ons in the palace. He keeps the Etrurian generals, Percival, Douglas, and myself, away from the king except in times of great urgency. But what about when you came to our raid in Ostia? That was an exception because I had Percival behind me. But I'm sorry, I didn't have the clout to prevent this. I don't blame you. We will return to Lysia as soon as we complete our mission here. But please, I only ask that you take care of Lysia in our absence. You needn't ask. The Lysian League is in safe hands, as is Princess Guinevere. Roy, may I not go with you? The battles on these islands are likely to be ugly. I can't predict what might happen. You should stay in hiding in Etruria with General Cecilia's protection. You can trust me, Your Highness. I know you want a truce to end this war. I will defend you to no matter the costs. I understand. I'm truly sorry to trouble you. Roy, I pray for your safety.
Thank you, Your Highness. I will pray for yours as well.
I just thought it was kind of weird how Guinevere follows Roy to the Western Isles only to, like, go back again. Must be quite the boat ride, you know? Anyway, I always start off here with a little bit of a torch. Wow, we can see very far. Oh my god. Yeah, so line of sight is definitely increased in Project Ember, which I think is okay, honestly. This map had really steep fog of war in original FE6. It was really hard to see anything, even with a torch. But yeah, looks like we have a horse lair. Gotta be careful about that. So what I like to do here is I like to pick up Roy. So what I'm going to do... Okay, how are we going to do this? Actually, I need to think. I need to pick up Roy, and then I need to give him to Shanna, actually. So I'm probably gonna have to use a mounted unit for that. So I'll use Marcus to pick up Roy like this. And I do believe Sue can pick up Roy, right? Yeah, she can. So she'll take. And then what? What's going on here? You should be able to take and give in the same turn. Or did Project Ember change this? That's so weird. So usually what I like to do is I like to give Roy over, put him on Shanna, so Shanna can drop him on the first turn. Or I don't usually do this with Roy, but in this patch I figured I might. Okay, well that's kind of stupid. Why can I not do this? This is so weird. Anyway, I'm gonna put Volt here. And... I ate some spicy food earlier. But yeah, that kind of bumps me out a little bit, honestly. But I guess this is how we're gonna do things then. So yeah, I'm gonna send everyone else down here. Guess I can use my iron sword to weaken this guy. Oh boy, oh pirates. Okay, look at him, look at him, look at him. He's gonna do a backflip. Whee! And whee! Oh, it's the coolest animation ever. I love it so much. And I think we're gonna... I can't let Trekkit... Wait, does Trekkit have less movement than Noah? No, he still has 7 move. Okay. I was starting to wonder there. I'm gonna send my mounted units down here to help. They can usually go around. I prefer to use Shanna to drop off everyone else. I feel like that's usually a smarter thing to do. I'm gonna heal up here. Chlorine needs to get her staff rank up so she can use the physic, but I'm gonna keep Sol on this island for the time being. Could actually use the torch on him, but oh well. Could have barriered Roy actually prior to picking him up, but oh well. It doesn't really matter. But, DBS, you can also go here. Ogier and Lou, you don't really get to rescue drop everyone, so you can send a couple of foot units along with the mounted units, even though they will be a little bit slower. Oh, no. No, 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 no. Don't hit Chlorine. Not very bad soldier. Very bad soldier. So, if Volt gets a crit here, which he does, that's really nice. Let's hope he doesn't get killed off by the other archer, though, because that would kind of suck. If I take out both of the archers right away... Very nice. If I take out both of the archers right away, maybe I can actually drop Roy off on the northern island. That would actually not be terrible. Huh. Very cool, Volt. Very cool. Alright, yeah, right. This is where Shin and Fear shows up. Scott!
Oh, Fear, sorry to call you in.
What's going on out there?
This island is under attack by pirates. They've come to kill the people living here.
What?
I sent some guys over to try and stop them, but the pirates are very skilled. The outlook isn't good.
I can't believe it.
I'd like to fight them myself, but I can't leave this place.
Fear, I'm sorry, but can you go in my place?
Yes, I will go and purge the people of these pirates.
Yeah, thanks.
Leave them to my blade. Anyone who attacks innocent villagers will get no mercy from me.
I have someone you can work with, too.
You do?
Yeah, he's a nomad named
Sin, really? I like Shin so much better.
He's a little skinny, but he's a decent shot with his bow.
Are you Shin?
Yes. I heard everything from Scott. Let's go.
So,
What?
Are you here to protect the villages like me?
No, I have no interest in such things.
Then why are you here?
I'm paid to fight, that is all.
I need to keep the conversation going.
Very relatable.
You're from Sakai, right?
Right.
What brings you all the way out here?
Nothing special. You look like you're from Sakai yourself.
As for me, I'm traveling around the leap to train myself and, Oh, you didn't ask me, did you?
I'm looking for someone.
Who?
My clan was crushed by Burn when they invaded Sakai. Our chieftain had me escape and told me to find and protect his granddaughter. I'm still in search of her.
I see. Well, I hope you find her.
Me too.
They'll show up eventually.
Boss, you sure? I mean, that girl won't have any chance.
I know what I'm doing. Once she's killed, we can take the sword she's carrying.
Sword? That weird one she has?
It's not just any sword. It's a Wu Dao, a famous blade from the East. It's worth a fortune.
Oh, I get it now. That's why you were so hospitable to her.
I couldn't do anything before, but now's our chance. I want you to follow her. Once she's finished, take the sword from her lifeless hands.
Sure thing, boss.
Alright, I don't know why Scott couldn't just kill Fear, but hey... details, I guess?
Alright, I'm gonna use the killer bow here just for the accuracy alone. There we go.
But yeah, I actually cleared out both of the archers on the northern village, or the northern island, which means... I mean, shouldn't be that unfeasible for me to just drop Roy off here. You know what? I think I will actually do that. As long as he has a rapier equipped, there's an armor knight there, but that's okay. This guy does have a ranged axe though, so what I could do is I could actually, I think Moroi has a, I'm gonna give him a full vulnerary. I'm just gonna do the light brand here. And yeah, I'm guessing I can't do the give trick, so that's not happening, I suppose. Kinda sucks, but you know, what can you do? Oh god, this guy has, I thought he was injured. Oh well. That was a bit annoying. I kind of wanted to give this kill to Trek. I don't know why I thought that guy was injured. Actually, it looks like Celot might have to do this. Unless I can... Nah, it's going to have to be Celot, isn't it? Actually, no. We can give the kill to Lou. Pretty sure we can at any rate. I do need to heal her up with a physic from Saul at some point. But I don't need to do that right away. Let's resort to a Thunder here. My Lou is ridiculously strong. Like, I just want to show you guys his stats. Because, okay, you'll see them now. I don't know how he got this good. 17 speed. 18 speed. Oh my god. He's so good. I don't know what happened to him. He just became a beast all of a sudden. It's ridiculous. Alright, make sure Noah has a steel sword. I know there's a horse lair around here somewhere. Silverlands. That's actually quite nasty. Maybe I actually should have put an axe on Celot, but... Oh well, nothing to be done about that right now. Anyway, Sue gonna do this. Marcus, follow suit. Honestly, Marcus could pick up Astor. Just carry him with him, why not?
Among the pirates is a very skilled nomad. You can't see him through all this fog, but he also has a girl with him.
Thanks, old man. Appreciate the advice. Yeah, I'll have Lilina accompany Roy at some point, I think. Like so. Yeah, I gotta be careful about that horse lair soldier. He can... Nah, it's not him. Ow. Okay, Celot is tanky, but Soldier has Silverlance. That's very nasty. Hopefully the axe guy won't kill him. I very much doubt it. I actually think he blocked off his friend. That's actually kind of funny. Yeah, he did. That's actually really cool. Alright, he's dead. And I can heal up with Chlorine next turn. Probably just gonna Physic with Saul, I think. Nice, Celot level up. Is this the first Celot level up? I think so. Wow, defense. I'm actually okay with this. And yeah, it looks like, by the way, the light brand apparently always... What the hell? Oh no! The light brand bug! Oh, this is so annoying. I gotta... Oh, so this wasn't fixed in the latest patch, apparently. Yeah. God, I'm such a moron. I'll be right back. Okay, ladies and gentlemen, we are back this time around. I did not even equip the light brand on Roy. I completely forgot about that. I think it has only happened with Roy so far, so it could just be that Roy don't really use the light brand well. Maybe I should just try and... I don't know. Let someone else wield it. Because it might be related to his animation, I think. I think it might occur whenever the light brand misses. I think that is what causes the bug. But I'm not sure. Didn't he have a 100% hit chance against that guy? I don't remember, but... Yeah, just something I need to be really careful about moving forward. Here we go. And as soon as it's safe against these fighters, I am going to try and drop Lalina over for that support. Hopefully they can do something on that island together. Oh, I actually could have attacked this guy. That was a bit of a dumb move by me. But hey, Astor gets the kills. So I guess it's fine. Man, like, this would never have hit in Vanilla FE6. Hand axe against Astor wielding a sword. Never. Never in a million years would it have hit. But hey, that's what happens when you increase the accuracy of axes. Wow. Luck. Best stat. Let's see. Anything to steal? Oh, this guy actually had a vulnerary to steal. I guess I'm not getting that now, then. Gotta be on the lookout. This guy has a horse there. Gotta be very careful about that guy. And this is a nice kill for Trek. Trek is a little lower level than Noah, so I'm gonna try to feed him a bunch of kills moving forward. And if we... Sue is actually being pretty useful here, just to chip stuff. I mean, I guess archers are just really good in Project Ember. But I'm looking forward to seeing Shin. He's probably gonna be my nomad of choice, I think. Hell, maybe we'll actually end up going to Sakai after all. You never know. Anyway, I'm gonna let myself be doubled here. This is fine. I think actually with an Iron Lance, Marcus wouldn't be doubled. He's still pretty fast. But this is fine. It gives Chlorine something to heal, so it's not necessarily a bad thing. Although, Chlorine can always resort to using the torch. So it doesn't really matter, I think. But it's still something to keep in mind. I do actually think you get another. I think you can buy torch staves, can't you, at some point? Alright, so this guy has an horse slayer. He probably murders Celot, I think, so I'm just gonna stay out of his range. So I think what I'll do is I'll put Celot right here with a lance. And that way, he can just deal with that guy when he shows up without pulling the horse slayer guy, because I think Celot can probably take a horse slayer to the face with weapon triangle advantage. I don't think that's particularly dangerous for him, but I'd still like to not. You know, I still like to not. Let's just put it that way. I'd like to not. All right, here we go. Celot gonna get doubled by mercenaries? Nah, he's a lot faster than Marcus, I think. He has more con too, so he doesn't get slowed down by the steel lance. Hey, Silver Rux! Probably unequip the rapier now. Ooh, sweet. Actually, come to think of it, maybe the life brand bug is tied to Roy's new class? Or his new animations? Could be. Ugh. Need a bow user to deal with that guy. Maybe Sue? I doubt Sue can do anything. I should have placed Sue there, actually. Ooh. A storm sword. That's interesting. So there are upgrades to the wind sword. That's kind of cool. Ah, these hit rates, man. These hit rates. I'm not a big fan. Alright, so if I kill the fighter, I think I can safely drop off Lalina outside of range of the Myrmidon. And I think I will. I still have a Physic from Sol, which should be able to top Roy off, even if he gets hit here. And he didn't, but I'm still going to top him off, because I want to play it safe. And yeah, as I said, I'm going to hold off visiting the villages to the very end of the map. And then we'll do both routes. I think that should please you guys. Okay, don't want Shauna to be in range of anything, really. So I'm just gonna do this. No enemies here. I didn't think there'd be. But still, I guess I took a little bit of a gamble. And I can almost kill this guy, actually. Almost. But I suppose what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna put OJ here with a Lance Reaver. And I'm not even going to attack this guy. I'm going to let my other guys finish him off. Marcus can chug a javelin. 8 damage. I mean, every little bit helps, right? Javelin. Oh, I hate how every attack looks like a crit. Every attack looks like a crit. There we go, let's heal up Roy. Thank God for physics, man. Thank God. I think I have a bullion on Shauna to sell. Did do that during battle preps. Yeah, a small bullion. So let's see if we can buy something useful in those stores. Honestly, looking at these guys, they probably just kind of moved with the rest of my guys. I don't think this is really saving a whole lot of time. Maybe if I could have done the rescue trick, it would have been different, but I can't, so. Alright, if I do this. Oh, Noah's actually taking damage. I might need to heal him with chlorine. Possibly. What if I use Trek? Don't think Noah is in range. Oh god, really, Trek? Come on. Really? Okay, I guess I'm just gonna have to use Jarrett then. Sell it. actually, that Lance Reaver is pretty. That can be pretty scary. Because that fighter is gonna have double advantage over me. I think I'll just use Sue, actually. Yeah, if I use Sue, I can kill this guy, but that still doesn't change. Maybe Sellot can actually go and kill the Axe Dude. That would probably be a good idea. Although I'm worried that Fear is gonna be close at this point. I'm actually very... Oh, that's right, Aster has... Nice! I keep forgetting. Completely changes the game when your thief can attack from two range, man. Alright, Trek, you go up here. And yeah, I think Sellot should be fine to do this. But no, actually he's not, because he's gonna take 34 damage from this guy, and that's just not gonna be nice. Ah, what am I gonna do? I can't even attack him from up here because the Great Knight has such shitty move. I'm just gonna have to pray, I guess, that... Okay, this guy has what? He has a Steel Axe, 27 damage. I mean, he has 88 hit on Ogier, who has 42 avoid. Double Weapon Triangle. Hey, the Soldier won't actually hit him. The Soldier will not hit him. And this guy will do 29 damage to Ogier. He'll be fine, actually. Yeah. Yeah, it's actually fine. He's going to dodge that attack 100%. There we go. And, I suppose I'll just put... I don't know, maybe the Axe guy wants to go for Sellot. I doubt he will, but there's a small chance that the AI might suddenly be stupid. It has happened before. Never know. Nah. Yeah, this is what I was worried about. But there is no chance in hell that Horslayer is hitting me. He's gonna have, like, so little chance to hit. So I think we're okay here. God damn it, OJ continues to level up like an absolute champ. What a good unit he is right now. Yeah, see? I mean, he actually did end up hitting me, but hey, that at least I didn't die, okay? That's literally thanks to the new weapon triangle advantage. Actually, no, the old one would have kept me alive as well. I'm dumb. Okay, I hope Roy can do something about that guy, because this is going to be an annoying battle. Actually, Shauna might be able to help out. I don't think there's any other units on the island. What if I move in Lilina? Actually, will she die? 10 speed? Yeah. Yeah, let's not. Let's not do that. What if we chip with the javelin first? Oh god. Oh god. That is so incredibly not nice. Could try a killing edge, maybe. Could work. Nah. It was worth a shot, though. So the question is right now, is it safe for Shauna to attack? God, Roy's gonna cap his speed. He's gonna cap his goddamn speed, guys. But I'm gonna move up here with chlorine. I'm gonna pop a torch. Could probably have done that on Aster instead. I don't know if this will actually give me any increased vision. Okay, there is an axe guy here. With a halberd, actually. But... yeah, that actually kind of changes things. I should have moved Lilina in first, but I suppose Roy can just eat the damage. Yeah, I suppose Roy will just have to eat the damage. Anyway, so here, I have no money, Jesus. I have absolutely no cash. I don't know, I think I'm good on torches. I don't need elixirs. I think maybe a lightning tome would be nice. I think another thunder tome would be nice as well. But yeah, I can actually put Lilina here in range of Roy, and he should be able to just eat another one of those, no problem. And I'm gonna let Aster kill this guy. Maybe Aster can actually see Fear now. She should be close. Actually, I should probably send Shauna down to visit the lower village, or maybe I can use one of my calves for that. Because the lower village does get targeted at some point. I think it has a silver blade or something? Yeah, there she is. Oh boy, I'm excited. Woo! Now those are some good stats. 16 base speed, 12 base strength. Yeah, this is a fantastic unit. She's gonna be so much fun to train. So, let's see if we can find her growth rates. Here they are. Have they changed her? Yes! 25% strength growth up to 40%. So much better, man. Skill growth increased, speed growth increased, luck growth has actually been decreased, as has her defense growth. And her resistance growth. So actually, her defensive growth rates went down. She's even frailer now, although she's much more sturdy in base, with 32 hit points. I don't know how significant hard mode bonuses are in Project Ember, if they changed the formula. But yeah, no, this is a fantastic unit right here. She actually has better bases than Rutger now. So yeah, I'm happy about this. So let's go recruit her with Noah. Well, without going into her range, preferably. So I'm gonna put Noah here. That should be enough, I think. And yeah, I'm gonna just murder this guy. And I'll send Noah can probably... Oh, do we want to go Noah Fear Support here? That'd be kind of funny, actually. But yeah, I'm gonna go and... actually gonna physic up Ogier. I know it's a bit dumb, but I want to pull that warrior this turn. Oh god. Yeah, maybe I can trick the archer into going for Sue. I think the archer will probably prefer to... I don't know, Sue doubles him. I'll just not move OJ forward this turn, I think. Or I could send Sella down. He's probably fine. Steel Axe hurts quite a bit. But he is very bulky, and he can be in... You know what? I think this is fine. I want Sella to start moving down. And he has both of his supporting buddies protecting him. So I actually think he'll be fine here. Here we go. Yeah, these guys on the island. Really good strategy there, Mangs. I know. I'm great at Fire Emblem, I swear. Uh-oh. Well, that was fucking dumb. I'm dead now, aren't I? No? Okay. But Archer is probably killing me now, right? Pretty sure. I don't know why I put Trek there. That was so dumb. No? Oh, okay. I guess he wasn't in range. Sweet. Well, okay. I'm very happy that Trek didn't get doubled. I guess I'm so used to Trek just being the slowest guy in the world that I just assumed he would get doubled by a warrior. But I'm happy to see that... The pre-promotes are scary stat-wise, but at least in terms of speed, they don't, like, double everything that you have. Alright, anything we want to get from here? I don't think so, actually. Might want to get a hammer. They're pretty good. And a wind edge for fear. Two wind edges for fear. There we go. I have no more money. The money is gone. Okay, well... The halberd fighter, if I put... Roy, like, here. He shouldn't have. I can do this quite easily with Lilina. Fire Tome is okay here. This is actually... I'm not a big fan of this after all. So, you know what? I'ma just do this. I'm just gonna play it safe, because that's one miss with bugged Binding Blade RNG, and it's a reset, and we don't want that, right? There we go. You guys can kiss and make love. Alright, here we go. Fear, it's you! Sir Noah, what are you doing here? I joined this army back in Ostia. Hey, whoa! What are you doing? Sheath your sword! Sir Noah, you aren't the nobleman I thought you were. What? I know you're a mercenary, but lending your service to pirates? You should be ashamed! What? Don't act like you don't know. You're working with pirates to attack the people living here. Are you call yourself a knight? Hold on, I think there's been some kind of misunderstanding. Misunderstanding? You still have the nerve? We're trying to help the villagers. Our goal is to defeat the head of the pirate group here. His name is Scott, I think. What? Scott is the head of the pirates? Sure is. If you don't believe me, why don't you ask the pirate over there? The one behind you, hiding in the bushes. Pirate? What pirate? Oh, the plan failed. I gotta go tell the boss. Hey, come back here. You didn't suspect them at all? No, Scott was very kind to me. Really? The rumors say he's a brute of a man. My mother always said you shouldn't judge a person by their looks. You know, that actually makes sense considering she met Bartra. Well, certainly, but I was fighting for the pirates this whole time. What should I do now? Do you want to come with us? Truly, can I? We're always on the lookout for new recruits to bolster our strength. I'll talk to Roy for you. Thank you.
Yay!
Fear, fear, fear. Fear is here, baby! I think Shin moves... Doesn't Shin, like, move eventually? I don't actually remember. But I'm gonna pop a torch to see what's on this island. We can also get a look at Scott, see how he is as a boss. Yeah, there he is. Ho ho ho! Yes! Yes! This is nice. 13, 13, 13. And how are his growth rates? Okay. Same strength, same skill, same speed, actually. He's very unchanged. A little bit higher luck, a little bit higher defense, same resistance. Okay. Shin is actually one of the most unchanged people growth rate-wise in Project Ember that I've seen so far. They didn't touch this guy at all. I think he has a... I don't remember his basis, but I don't think they were this good originally, so... Yeah, this I'm fine with this. Sometimes you don't really need to change the unit much. Shin was always a pretty solid unit. So we need to get Sue up here. Oh, actually, probably wasn't the best idea to have Sue be all the way around here, wasn't it? And here's Scott, still terrifying. Jesus Christ. This guy is a nightmare to deal with. And yeah, I don't want... I could pull Shin closer with fear, I guess. I still think he attacks her. Just gonna make sure... Oh, he has a killer bow, actually. Never mind. I am not doing that. I am absolutely not doing that. But yeah, I think... can Trek actually kill this guy? That would be kind of cool. I don't think he can, but it would be nice. Actually, I might be able to give the kill to Trek. That would be hilarious. There we go. And as long as I heal Trek up to full health with Chlorine, I think we should be fine here. Now, there are a lot of pirate reinforcements on this map, and I know I advocated grinding on them in the pirate in the fear spotlight. I don't think I'm gonna do that, personally. You can do it, if you want to. It's a lot of fun. But I think fear is gonna be completely okay to level on our own here. Normally in vanilla FE6, fear does need a couple of levels to get going. More than a couple, honestly, she needs a lot of levels to get going. But, here in Project Ember, I don't see fear being hard to level at all, especially considering she has access to 1-2 range swords. So she's gonna be pretty easy to level up for the most part, I do believe. Oh, would you look at that? It's a kill for Mr. XP Police. There we go. So now I just gotta go down, visit the village, and take care of the boss, and that should conclude our negotiations. Flux. Salad is pretty tanky. He can take a flux and an axe, right? Pretty sure that's the case. Let's just get a vulnerary in just because, you know, it helps. And yeah, Sue needs to hightail it up here, because I do think Shin moves eventually. I don't think she moves right away, or he moves right away, but he moves at some point, I do believe. There seems to be less... No, he moves right now. I don't know... if there's less units on the island, or if they show up as reinforcements. I don't remember which is which. But there are a lot of reinforcements on this map in general. Alright, Halberd going for Roy, that's fine. And now he's dead. Easy peasy. Here comes the Shaman. We haven't been facing a lot of those so far. I don't recall there being any Shamans on this map by default either. There's not a lot of generic Shamans in FE6 overall. Really. You start encountering a lot of Druids in the endgame, but aside from that, not really. Anyway, I'm gonna pick up Sol. Because, you know, we always gotta call Sol. It's important. Ah, okay, so this kind of sucks. I do believe Shin will attack Sue. So that's not great. We actually have to get out of... I think he does. Don't quote me on this, but I think he does. So we actually have to get out of his range now, or else we're going to die. So I'll do this. Yeah, I'll just get out. Get out. Let's not take any chances. I don't remember how his AI works exactly. It would make sense if he didn't attack Sue, but I'm not going to trust that he does. There we go, and honestly, you two can just Yeah. Sit here and become girlfriend and boyfriend, please.
Fire Emblem pairing, man. That's how it works. Just put units next to each other.
It's how it's always worked.
And yeah, looks like Team Old Boys right here gonna go down to the village. I don't think the initial pirates go for the villages, but I think older reinforcements does, if I remember correctly.
Is this safe? 17 damage. I'm actually not a big fan of this. Oh no.
I am not. No. I didn't see that sniper there. Holy crap. Stealable Orion's Ball. Yeah, no, that village is toast, I think. I think I was too slow.
Yeah, that was scary. I don't want anything to do with that. Thank you very much.
But Stealable Orion's Ball, that was not here before.
Oh, what? No!
Oh my god, he doesn't double, but still, this is scary. No. Oh, three rich bows, why? Oh.
Okay, I need to get Shin to do something. Oh god, look at that resistance he has, holy shit.
Okay, this map just turned very nasty very quickly. I gotta be very careful now.
Can I even get out of Shin's range? I think I need to place Roy there.
Roy has very good luck, so it should be okay. Oh god, the sniper moves.
Alright, please don't attack Sue. That's all I'm asking, just please. Could I try and get him into heal mode, maybe? I don't think there's any way for me to do that.
I just have to run away with Lilina, or at least get... I can actually keep her within Roy's support range, which is fine. But yeah, he's probably gonna go for Sue now, I imagine. 13 speed. He's not gonna double her. But Sue can retaliate, so hopefully... And my Roy is ridiculously bulky and has a lot of luck, so hopefully Shin's not gonna kill him. But I have other things to worry about right now. I have to... I can probably... come to think of it, I can probably just surround that sniper now. Steal his Orion's Bolt and just chip him with Fear. I also should probably trade an Iron Sword over to Fear. The Wu Dao is good, you definitely shouldn't hoard it, but you definitely shouldn't overuse it either. There we go. Definitely want to try and get that sniper killed with Fear. Hit points, speed, luck, and resistance. Hey, she can actually attack him right away. Ooh. I might actually be able to kill him right now, which would be pretty badass. Actually, no, I don't want to kill him right now. I want to steal his Orion's Bolt. What am I talking about? There we go. Thank you. Appreciate it. I wonder if I missed out on any promotional items so far, since I'm not very good at checking ranges. Is that a Pegasus Knight? No, it's just a pirate. Should be safe for Lu to do this, hopefully. Oh, wow. Lu actually... Huh. Okay. All right. Well, might as well do this. If he dies, he dies. If he dies, it's meant to be. If not, we feed the kill to Fear. Actually, if we do a rescue, we might actually be able to kill him right away, which would be kind of hilarious. Yeah, I actually think we can. Yeah, look at that. We can. Rescue Astor, or Astolfo, and kill with Wu Dao.
Oh, look at her new and updated model! Oh, it's so adorable! Oh, she looks super cute! I love it!
Okay, now it's probably safe to do this, I imagine. I hope. Yeah. Please, God, do not attack. Please do not attack Sue. Just keep shooting Roy, please, because I'm pretty sure Roy takes a crit. Yep, good. Does he take a crit? Yep, he does, actually. He does take a crit. At least when he's next to Lilina. So that's good to know. Oh, and would you look at that? That is another kill for Fear. Very, very cool. And the pirates still haven't reached a village. It's strange. They should have it now, right? No, it's not. Wow. Pretty sure I played way too slowly for this, but... Okay. Anyway, I'm gonna trade a sword. Not a steel sword, though. But I can... No. Oh, actually, I don't have... Ooh. OJ's all the way up there. What about Marcus? He can reach Fear, actually. There we go. Yeah, I'm gonna try and reach Fear with Marcus and do this, so...
Because I want to try and save the Wudao just a tiny bit. Like, for example, here, it makes no sense to use the Wudao when I could just do this. And yeah, look at that. She's leveling up amazingly. Well, we'll see about that. That's fantastic. I love it. 13 strength already. So much better than OG Fear. Holy crap. Okay, and yeah, I'm gonna make an attempt to reach the village, even though I'm pretty sure it's too late. But who knows? This guy has a silver axe. Not a big fan. Can I just kill him? Not really, no. Does he one-shot Lou? No, it's pretty close. But I think I'll just... Honestly, he might be more tempted to go for fear in this situation. So if I just do this, then it should be fine, right? Anyway, I'm a physic up Roy, and again, just gonna pray that Shin keeps going for him, even though Sue is in range. I know that there is an AI in Fire Emblem where they don't attack friends. Like, I know Douglas will never attack Lorem, for example. I'm very confident of that. But I don't know if Shin has this AI. I guess we're just gonna have to find out. But yeah, I'm not putting OJ in this range, that's for sure. I'm gonna let Celup be healed up here before I do anything else. Yeah, let's go get Debius. Woo! Woo! Alright. Dropping Roy off on the Northern Island, probably not one of my finest moves. Okay, no, he still goes for Roy. Good. So he won't attack Sue, no matter what. Either that or he doesn't like getting countered by her. It's one of the two. It's difficult to know, really. No, okay, the pirate still goes for Lou. Thought maybe he'd go for Fear. She should be an easier target, but... Eh. Anyway, let's go and kill Scott, shall we? Oh, what the hell? Are you shitting me? A Fimbulwit or Sage? Okay. Alright, didn't see that coming. I guess that's my fault for not scouting ahead, though, but okay. Did he vanish? Oh my god, okay, no, he vanished because the line of sight ended. Okay, well, I'll be right back. Alright, welcome back, ladies and gentlemen. We are pretty much at the end of this map at this point. I was really close to reaching the boss, so I played a little bit further off screen. Still not able to reach the village, but the pirates don't seem to really want to go for it, so okay, I guess. But I'm gonna try and kill the boss with fear, because I always think that's hilarious. So I'm gonna see if I can't bring him down a little bit first. If I could make him not equip his killer axe, that'd be nice. The pirate reinforcements have also started appearing. People say, due to 3 range, can't you just cheese all the bosses in this game? And the answer is, yeah, kinda.
Maybe the fog didn't stop you, but you must be in rough shape at least. I'll finish you off.
Pretty much, like you can just do this. There's nothing preventing you from doing it. 3 range bows are pretty exploitable in terms of bosses, but it'll take you some time, and I wouldn't really say it's, I wouldn't say it's the most valid strategy in the world, but hey, it'll certainly chip him down if that's what you wish. So there's a lot of reinforcements on this island, though, so we gotta be a little careful. I could do this if I want to. I could probably kill him this turn, actually, but I'd like to do it with fear, if at all possible, because I don't know, there's just something very poetic about it, don't you think? I'm gonna visit this house right here. The nearby villagers, they're all deserting the isles for the mainland. It's very sad, really. If you want to visit, you'd best do it quickly. You won't have time to go to both, so you'll have to decide. Says who? Alright, so... Got a lot of guys coming in here. I think I'm gonna send Celup to visit the village. No pirates here. It's good to see. Man, Marcus and Celup should have had a support. I would have loved that support. Just two old guys being old and badass, you know? It's like, hey, Marcus, how's the carrying going? Yeah, no, it's just carrying the youngsters, you know? You know how it be, Celup? Yeah, yeah. We sure got good bases. Yeah, sure do, buddy. Man, imagine having bad bases. I don't know how that feels like. I always had good bases. Yeah, me too. Almost capped speed on a stall for right now. Pretty sweet. So yeah, you can stay behind and milk these reinforcements for quite a while if you want to. And there's some decent experience in it for you for sure. But I never really saw the... I mean, that's not true. I love doing it. But I'm not going to do it for this Let's Play. Yeah, I finished shopping with Shauna. Going to make a save and visit both the villages. gonna show off basically what I'm gonna do. I'm gonna visit the right hand village last, I think, because I'm going to visit the right hand village first, because I'm going Echidna. Here we go. Does he double mercenaries now? Nah. But I'm still pretty sure Myroy's gonna cap his strength. Ooh, hi. Yeah, this village, never liked this section of the map. There's some, like, the fog, unless you bring a thief with you, there's always, oh god, no. Ugh. Holy shit. Ugh. That feel, man. That feel. Alright, I gotta get this guy out of the way now. Holy shit. And I gotta be careful, because Scott has that hand axe. And it's... That hand axe is very, very nasty. Okay, we got basically... I'll be fine. Like, I'm on a good luck roll today. I'm not gonna miss a 94. There we go. We can just get this mage out of the way, which we should be able to do with Shin. And I don't think there's any other units on this island, although I'm not entirely sure. But yeah, I'm just gonna murder this guy. Did Shin come with a killer boat base? I think he did. So, or was it a short boy? I actually don't remember. But yeah, if I start leveling up Shin like crazy now... Wow! We might actually go to Sakai, guys. It could happen. It very well could happen. Alright, Roy's on low health. This is kind of scary, but... I think I'm done with the reinforcements on that island, so we should be okay here. Maybe OJ can have some fun against the boss. I don't know. If I still had his personal, I could probably have some fun, but I'm not gonna do it. I could try to maybe force him to throw an axe at me, but with axes being buffed the way they are, 85 hit, I'm just not... I don't really want the guy to attack me at all, you know? So I'm just not gonna do it. This whole era is basically pirate territory. They take everything from us. Resist, you say? It's of no use. They can do whatever they want because of their numbers. We can't fight against them like the resistance force. But here's the silver sword that we had lying around. Might as well take it, you know? Astolfo ends up being the guy who grinds on the pirates in this episode. I haven't given Fear as much experience as I would have liked. This guy has a range. I guess we can do this. You know what, Trek? Why don't you go and earn some experience, too, you know? Might as well do it. Alright, I really hope there's no enemies lurking in the fog here. That would be really sad if it was the case. But I think I know my FE6 pretty well. There's just pirates left at this point. Oh, they're actually going for the villages. That's kind of funny. But I plan to kill the boss this turn anyway, so it should be fine. Ugh. Trek, you're starting to resemble FE6 Trek a little bit too much for my taste here, buddy. Yeah, god, these short axes, man, they're really accurate. I don't like this. Way too accurate for me. Also, when do I get to buy knives? Is that something I'd like to do? Thank you very much. Okay, here we go. Oh god, did he heal to, like, full? What the hell? Or did I just not attack him this time? Actually, I don't remember. Anyway, let's go. Yay. It's a good thing that he's wielding a killer axe normally here. Normally this guy's a nightmare to hit because of the high avoid bonuses the thrones give you, but now he's still very bulky, but so much more manageable now. No! Don't do this. I'm gonna get the kill with Fear. Go get him. Go get him, Volts. Alright, just a little more now. 23. I don't think it's slow enough for where Fear can get the kill, but we could go... Oh god, yeah, look at that crit rate, man. It's freaking nightmare. Yeah, that's not happening. I'm sorry. I think I'm just gonna... Oh, I hate Binding Blade bosses, man, with a pat. This is so scary, man. This is 52 crit. Like, what the hell? Okay, I guess I... Really? Roy can't pick up his own girl? What the hell? Yeah, I'm staying one more turn. I'm staying one more turn. I am not dealing with that. Just not dealing with that. And, I don't really have a way to fight those pirates, do I? I mean, I have Shauna, but that's... She can't really do much from here. Trek didn't hit this guy, so that kind of sucked. You can hit this guy, but I'm starting to worry that if he has more bad luck, he's gonna... Yeah. Wait. I hope they didn't amp up the healing of the gates in Binding Blade, because I swear to God I hit Scott with a couple of hits, and now he's almost at full health, so I'm gonna watch his HP this turn, see if it... Alright, I need to heal up Astolfo with Chlorine now. God, I'm looking forward to Rogue Astolfo. I probably could just early promote him already, but he's getting experience so quickly as a thief, I just don't see any point. Alright, might as well break this man's staff, there we go. And is it safe for Trek to stay here? Steel Axe, Steel Axe. Oh, wait. Okay, they have Short Axes and Steel Axes. Think it's safe? I hope so. There you go. Good job, Trek. And yeah, next turn, we will kill Scott. Next turn, we'll get him, boys. We'll get him. And yeah, let's just visit the house with Marcus. What are they saying here?
There's so much mist here. In these conditions, you can never know if someone is waiting to pounce. Torches can be very useful, even if you have an eagle-eyed thief with you.
Yeah, use the torch on the thief. That's how you do it. Alright, let's... No, he doesn't have increased healing. I guess I just didn't hit him as hard as I thought I did.
Ow.
Okay, thank God the other guy doesn't have a range tax, or else Trek would have been dead right now. Hit points, luck, defense. Cool. Trek level up. Very Trek. Alright, I'm wasting my knives again, but... Ooh, never mind. I do hope they get available from armories at some point, though. It would be very sad if they're, like, a limited item. Alright, well, let's just hope I hit him then. Oh, very nice. Ah, beautiful. I think Fierce should be able to get the kill now. With her increased base strength. Yep, quite easily too. Always thought it was kind of sad that they didn't have a battle cloak.
Who in Alib are you? You're no ordinary army.
That should be a full level. Yeah, it's a full level. Let's go. Let's get the same level up you got last time, please. Whee! Ha ha ha! Lucky. Alright. I'm gonna just kill what I can here, then I'm gonna get the hell out. Oh, actually, no. I need to make a save state. So yeah, we're gonna go Echidna route first. So, yeah. Time to make a save state, I guess. So I'm gonna do this. And then we're gonna visit the leftmost village. I think that's the one that gives the killer bow.
The only people here are women or children. All the workers have been taken north to the mines. They aren't even allowed to rest. They're forced to work until they die. My brother escaped, but he was reduced to skin and bone. The first day he came back, he was already too weak, and he drew his last breath. Now that I told you this, can you... sorry. I said too much. Please forget all of this. We'll leave the Isles now.
Yeah, so that's how you get a kid now. So yeah, I'll just load the save when I come back, and I'll show you guys both routes. Simple as that. Merlinus, it appeared the enemy was trying to ambush us. They must have known we were coming. I think there's more to this than we realize. You're right. Clearing out the bandits may be more difficult than expected. Ever since Burn's aggressive behavior started, Halib has changed. I don't even know what to expect. Dragons appearing? Burn's sudden invasion? The collapse of the Elysian League? Everything has happened so quickly. In the end, I suppose all we can do is take it one problem at a time. Now, where do we go from here? Let's move north along the coast. North? Toward the mines? Yes. I heard the people on the islands are being forced into slave labor there. So you think we should rescue them? If we do, we might be able to find out who's behind all this. Well, we must start somewhere. Then let's not waste time. Let's head north. Alright. Okay, ladies and gentlemen. That was a fun map. Looking forward to training Fear. It's going to be a lot of fun. Looking forward to seeing both Echidna and Bartra in Project Ember. Another solid map. Not many changes, but I don't mind. It's fun. The Fimbulvetcher Sage was a bit of a dick move, though. Like, I understand, I should have lit a torch with Astor, but... that felt a little unfair, but... Oh well. I'll see you guys in the next part. Bye-bye!